Good morning students. Today class, I am going to discuss about the important force in this chapter, that is friction force or frictional force. What is frictional force? Let us see that. It is actually a contact force. So, that always acts normal to the surface. Okay, what is actual friction? Let us see that. What is the basic definition? It is the force which opposes the relative motion or tendency of relative motion between two bodies in contact. So, from where this force has been arisen, that is the important thing, right? Take a ball or take a pen, anything. So, apply some force on this pen. What happens? It moves with some velocity. While it is moving, its velocity go on decreases. After traveling some distance, it comes to rest. According to Newton, if a body is moving with uniform velocity, no need of external force, right? But here, when you use some force on this body, it starts to move, and while it is moving on the surface, slowly comes to rest. What makes it comes to rest is that force is frictional force. That force is what, ma? Frictional force. How it comes? Let us take an example. This is a surface. It appears to be smooth, but it is not smooth surface. There are some irregularities in the surface. So, this actually, it appears as what? A smooth surface. But if you seen through a microscope or through any device, it appears to be a rough surface. Now, an object is placed on this surface. Let us assume that this is also a smooth surface, but it has the same irregularities, right? Yes, it has also what? Some irregularities. Now, what happens? These irregularities are merged. Means, for example, this is a rough surface and this is another rough surface. They are merged like this on the surface, right? Now, if the body wants to start to move, what we should act against this force or not? There is an opposing force acts on the body which not makes the body to move. That force is called what? Frictional force, that exists only when the body wants to start to move. If the body is at rest, no frictional force. Means the frictional force acting on the body is zero. When it thought to move from the surface, when it want to move towards some point, then one opposing force will come into existence which opposes this relative motion between these two bodies, means between surface and the body. That force is called what? Frictional force. This is also a vector quantity. His direction is always normal to the surface. And this friction, what is friction? It is the force which opposes the relative motion between two surfaces. Means when an object both are at rest, for example, these both surfaces are at rest, there is no frictional force. When the body starts to move, then this will opposes the motion of this one. That opposing force, when there is a relative motion between these two surfaces, is called frictional force. This frictional force has been initially classified into two types. First, basically, that is, one is called static friction and the one is called kinetic friction. And there is one more type also there, later we have discussed that one, that is called rolling friction. Static friction, kinetic friction and rolling friction. So, we will learn in detail what is these frictions and how the force will act on these bodies. What is first one? Static friction. The name itself explained. Friction means we got one idea. What that? It is the opposing force that exists when there is a relative motion between two bodies, right? Static means what? Rest. Static means what? Rest. So we can easily say, right, when two bodies in contact are not moving with respect to each other, the force of friction between them is called what? Static friction. When two bodies in contact are not moving, yes, we said already it is at rest, are not moving with respect to each other, with respect to each other, the force of friction between them is called static friction. So when two objects are rest, the force of friction that present between them is called what? Static friction. Okay, so we already said that there is no relative motion, there is no friction. Now I will explain this concept in a simple way, that for example there is a body having irregular surfaces like this of both bodies. Now I apply some force, you can also apply some force. The body is heavy, what happens? It won't move. Yes, when the force is applied, the body starts to move in forward direction, then will come into existence what? A frictional force. In which direction? Here, that is in this direction, Fs. A frictional force will start to come in this direction. If I increase the force from 10 to 20, this frictional force also increases from 10 to 20. If again increase the force, this static friction also increases. So when the applied force keep on increases, the static friction also keep on increases up to one limit. Up to one limit means the maximum force that can oppose by the static friction has been caused. Then the body starts to move. Until then, the body will be at rest. Means if a body wants to move, if you want to push a body or pull a body, you should apply a force which is more than the maximum force exerted by static friction. That maximum force exerted by static friction is called limiting friction. The maximum force that exerted by the frictional force or static friction is called what? Limiting friction. This static friction has one ideal behavior. What is that? Is this is a self-adjusting force. This is a self-adjusting force. What that? How we can say that self-adjusting force? If a light force, external force is 10 newtons, frictional force also 10 newtons. If we increase to 20, the frictional force also increases to 20. If it is 5, it comes to 5. So depending upon the applied force, what happens? The frictional force has been changing. Which frictional force? Static friction. So that's why this is called what? Self-adjusting force. When you apply external force on any object, the body, the friction also increases in opposite direction and doesn't want to make it to move. But until one limit. What that limit is called? Limiting friction. The maximum force that can oppose by the frictional force, when there is a relative motion between two bodies, is called what? Static friction. That friction is called what? Limiting friction. This is having a property called what? Self-adjusting force. When there is no applied force, there is no force. When the force increases, the frictional force also increases and reach a maximum value. That is called what? Limiting friction. Okay? So When the applied force exceeds this maximum friction, the body starts to move. Okay, so we can say that if the applied force is more than limiting friction, then the body starts to move. The body starts to what? Move. So, Fs is directly proportional to N. What is Fs? Static friction. And what is N? Normal force. Again, this depends upon nature of material, right? Fs is equals to mu s into N. What is mu s? Where mu s is proportionality constant called coefficient of static friction. Coefficient of static friction you can define as what? Mu s is equals to F s by N. So, what is F s? Maximum static friction to normal reaction. It is defined as what? Maximum ratio of maximum static friction to N is what? Normal reaction. Normal reaction, as we know, that always acts upon the body in upward action. See, this weight acting downwards, then the normal force act upwards. Fs is this one and this is external force, right? So, we said that already the frictional force direction is perpendicular to the direction. So, this is the perpendicular. So, Fs is directly proportional to N, then Fs is equals to what? Mu s into N. So, this frictional force is always less than or equals to Us into N, right? And one more thing is what? This Fs is independent of area of contact. Means how much area has been contact with the surface, it is independent. It may be completely dependent or a small part also, the value remains same. It is independent of area of contact. So, this is what kind of, static friction. And you can easily say that. Next one is what? Kinetic friction. What is kinetic friction? When the body, we apply force and finally, the body starts to move. When the body starts to move also, there is a relative motion or not? Yes. Again, the force will oppose us. Which force? Frictional force. When it is in motion, that frictional force is called what? Kinetic friction. Because it is in motion, we consider it as what? Kinetic. See, when one body slides on the surface of another body, the force of friction between them is called what? Kinetic friction. So, when one body starts to slide, on the surface of another body, there exists the friction, right? That friction between these two bodies is called what? Kinetic friction. Same case here also, the kinetic friction depends upon what? Normal reaction, because when the body starts to move, there exists a normal force. So it is dependent by what? Fk. Fk is what? Fs is static friction, then Fk is kinetic friction, right? So now from this, Fk is equals to mu k into n. The same thing we should write, what that, where mu k is proportionality constant called what? Coefficient of kinetic friction, called what? Coefficient of kinetic friction. This can also be defined as what? Mu k is equals to Fk by n. What is Fk? The ratio of force of kinetic friction of body to normal reaction. The ratio of force of kinetic friction to normal reaction of the body, right? So as we know, Fk is less than F maximum or Fs, then we can clearly say that mu k is less than mu s. In the same way, this also does not depend upon area of contact. So if a body force applied on the body, the velocity of the body will decreases and finally the body will stop. See, we already said that if the force we applied on this body, it starts to move. Whatever the force we applied is more than kinetic friction, then the body keep on moving. If it is less than kinetic friction, what happens? Slowly the body comes to rest. So that is the reason the body comes to rest, because of the presence of what? Kinetic friction. So if applied a force on a body, for example, this is a mass, I applied some force on this body, there exists which force? Kinetic friction in opposite direction. What is the acceleration of the body? A is equals to F minus Fk by M. A is equals to what? F minus Fk by, okay. So this is about what? Kinetic friction. And the last one is rolling friction. What is rolling friction? If a body starts to roll, it opposes, obviously, if it is rolling or moving, the friction when one body is rolling on the surface of another body, the friction when one body is rolling on surface of another body, rolling on surface of another body is called rolling friction. So this rolling friction also, let us represent that R is directly proportional to N. That implies Fr is equals to mu r into n. What is mu r? Coefficient of which friction? Rolling friction. You can define this as mu r is equals to Fr by n. What is Fr? Friction of rolling, and n is normal reaction, right? Now from all these cases, we should say that main point, what? That coefficient of static friction or coefficient of rolling friction, sorry, kinetic friction or rolling friction, does not have any dimension, because this is a force, this is also force. Now since mu r is less than mu k, we can say that finally mu s is greater than mu k is greater than mu r. See, we can easily say this phenomena as When a body is at rest, it is difficult to apply force, right? For example, have you seen that in cricket ground there is a lawn roller, pitch roller, it is having more weight. Eventually it is at rest, so we required a lot of force to pull that roller because static friction is more, we have to apply more and more force. When the object starts to roll, it easy to roll, means the force what we applied initially is very less as compared to while it is rolling, because static friction is more than kinetic friction as compared to rolling friction. So that's why it is very easy to roll a body than a body to move. So this is about what friction and its types. In the next class we'll discuss clearly what are the laws of refraction, laws of friction, advantages and disadvantages, and how to reduce friction. Clear, students? Thank you.